Hello students, let's start our English language class, and today we will start a new chapter, chapter 3, and it is a prose, it named as The Mountain That Ate People, a peculiar name I think. So firstly we before we start the story, here is a ponder for us. Having been for a long time an island nation that like to keep to itself, Japan has a very unique culture. Japan, you know, the island country, it has a very unique culture. Not only high art and culture, but even television shows or cartoons or knickknacks from Japan are instantly recognizable. Okay, here are some commonly heard Japanese terms and what they mean. Firstly, Cowboy Bebop. Actually, this is called as anime or animated films and shows. They have distinctive character design and expressions. This is part of Japanese culture actually. Next is manga. Manga are comic books. They are typically black and white and episodic in nature. And the next is samurai. Samurai were members of the historical military officer class, along with their martial skill. Martial arts are famous there. They were famed for their strict sense of honor and discipline. And here is a sushi. It is a dish, a recipe made of rice and meat or seafood, vegetables, fruits, often wrapped in seaweed. Both sushi and sushi chefs are highly respected all over the world. So here we just look at part of culture, Japanese culture. And now the story. Firstly, Hima Pandey is the author of this story. She born on 1928. She is an author of children's books and best known for her translation of Japanese folk tales. Actually, folk tales, that means lokkathai. Jo aise saalon se chalte aate hai kuch bhi, koi bhi region par, which have been published in many anthologies. So let's start the story. Long, long ago in Japan, there was a small state ruled by a young feudal lord who hated old people. So, long ago in Japan, the island nation, there was a small state. Firstly, I have to tell you the meaning of feudal. Isn't it feudal? Feudal lord, it means a person who had large number of land. Zamindar, they are. Landowner, we can say. So, long ago in Japan, the island nation, there was a small state, and the ruler was a feudal lord and he hated old people. "What a great nuisance these old folks are," he cried. "They can neither work nor think, are utterly useless, and should all die after their 61. So he thought that the old people are useless. So they should die after the age of 61. 60 actually is a age after that people are called as old actually. So that feudal lord thought that they are useless and they should die at 61. So he issued a decree. Decree, that means a notice, official order or decision, official notice, etc. So he issued a decree and threatened that whoever broke it would be punished most severely. Oh, what a cruel feudal lord he was! How his people feared him! The terrified people, weeping and sorrowful, were forced to take their old parents when they became 61 to the dense forests on the high mountain near the city and leave them in the cold and rain at the mercy of wild animals. So that cruel feudal lord, उन्होंने वो नोटिस जारी की कि जब भी 61 होने पर उनकी पिता माता जो भी होते हैं 61 एज आफ्टर द 61 एज सबको वो जंगल में छोड़ के आना पड़ेगा. एंड द फॉरेस्ट्स एंड इन द फॉरेस्ट द वाइल्ड एनिमल्स विल एट देम अप. So this mountain came to be known as the mountain that ate people. For that, the mountain, as the old persons didn't come back from that wild from that dense forest, and the wild animals ate them up. So that the mountain that the mountain was known called as the mountain that ate old people. Soon, there were hardly any old people left, and the feudal lord was jubilant. Jubilant means that extremely happy. There was no people left. All are gone in the forest, and the wild animals ate them up. So the feudal lord was very happy. "Now my state will surely prosper. We are all young and energetic, and have no aged folk to hinder and trouble." So he thought that his state will prosper shortly because there was no old people and all are young people, and the aged give no trouble to them. Okay. "Now there was a farmer who lived with his mother and loving her dearly, never did anything without her advice." एक फार्मर था, वो उसकी माँ के साथ रहते थे, उसकी माँ को बहुत प्यार करते थे, इसीलिए विदाउट his mother he can't live, and without her advice he can't live. But everyone grows old with time. His mother too grew old, the farmer's mother. Soon his mother too turned 61. So the farmer's mother at last turned 61, and since they had lived in the village all their lives, it was impossible to hide her age. It was not possible to hide the farmer's mother's age because they live for a long time. How terribly upset the poor farmer was. The farmer was very upset because he had to he had to take her, his mother to the jungle and live there. Even at night, he tossed and turned, unable to sleep with worry and fear. Till one day, the mother called him and said, "Son, I am now 61. He feared to leave her mother, but one day his mother told him that, "Now I am 61. Please take me quickly to the mountain and leave me there. The longer you delay, the more miserable you shall be. And the heartless Lord will punish you fearfully. Don't be sad for me, since we must all die someday." So his mother consoled her and told her that, "You please leave me there in the jungle, because it is the decree of the Lord, of the heartless feudal lord. Otherwise, there will be a miserable time for them." "Oh, mother, forgive me," sobbed the unhappy man. "I cannot do this." But because of her insistence, he agreed to take her at last. Lastly, as his mother, farmer's mother, insisted him, he agreed to take her. Since she was unable to go up by herself, he took her up on his back and, with tears trickling down his face, climbed up silently and slowly. You can see here in the picture how he took her up on his back. The farmer took her mother on his back. The narrow path wound up through the dark and desolate forest. Desolate means here joyless, sorrowful forest. As the in the forests, all the sons, they kept their mother or father, so that gradually even the trail could hardly be seen in the falling dusk. The farmer had to part the tall grasses and lift the overhanging foliage as he climbed higher and higher. Foliage is the leaves of a plant. The farmer part the tall grasses and then lift the overhanging foliage, and he climbed then. Crack! Suddenly the old mother, perched on his back, broke off a twig from a tree. Twig, that means a small branch of tree. The mother, farmer's mother, just perched on his back. She broke off a twig. Hardly had the farmer taken a few wary steps more, then crack! She broke another. Again, crack, crack. The puzzled young farmer stopped. "Mother, why are you breaking so many twigs?" he asked. So the farmer stopped there. He became confused. Why his mother breaking twigs? For that he asked her. "I am breaking and throwing them down," replied the mother calmly. "I know that I will not be alive by tomorrow, but it will be extremely dangerous if you lose your way returning home."
फिर वो जंगल से फिर आए, तब उसको पता चले कि रास्ता कैसे किधर है. इसलिए ओके.
जस्ट नाउ इट्स डार्क, बट व्हेन द मून राइजेस यू विल फाइंड योर वे बैक सेफली.
फॉलोइंग दिस ट्विग्स थ्रू दिस डिसमेल फॉरेस्ट. डिसमेल दैट मीन्स ग्लूमी फॉरेस्ट. Hearing her loving words, the farmer wept bitterly as he helped her down to the stony ground. Hearing his words, so loving words. Actually, each mother loves his loves her son or daughter very much. So that the feeling of that, the farmer wept very much. And mother, he cried, even at such a terrible time as now, how can you still think of me, even though I am carrying you to your death, he sobbed. So the farmer wept and said, I am carrying you to your death, even that you can thought like this. There is nothing strange about my thoughts, smiled the mother gently. I was so joyful when you were born and never minded any hardships to bring you up. My son, it's very natural for me to care and think of you. So his mother replied, when he was born, then and after that, there was no hardship to bring him up. So it's very natural for her, for the mother, to think like that. Never, never I'll leave you, mother, in this dreadful place, cried the farmer. I will gladly accept any punishment from the feudal lord rather than let you die here. And he picked his mother up again. So the farmer denied to leave her there, and he picked his mother up again and pick her way to home. So both of them returned down. They returned to home then, returned down the mountain that ate people and quietly hid among the bushes on the edge of the forest. When the entire village was fast asleep, they crept back stealthily to their little home. So both of them returned down the mountain, and when all the villages were asleep, then they back to their लिटिल होम. वो उसको फार्मर ने उसको माँ को लेकर उसके घर पे फिर वापस चले आए. सो दिस मच फॉर टुडे, एंड इन आवर नेक्स्ट क्लास आई विल टेल यू द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी. ओके, सो टिल देन यू रीड द स्टोरी सेवरल टाइम्स एंड ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. ओके, एंड बाय फॉर टुडे. And you all stay safe.